every cell in my body vibrates with energy and health. Loving myself heals my life. I nourish my mind, body, and soul. I'm so in love with this affirmation by Louise Hay. She says that you have the power to heal your life, and you need to know that. We think so often that we are helpless, but we are actually not. We always have the power of our minds. So all we need to do is claim and consciously use this power. For many people, illness, loss of health, represents the crisis situation that triggers an awakening. So guys, today in this video I wanted to share my interpretation and perspective of being healthy. So generally we talk about health and we mean the state of being free from illness or injury, correct? But according to World Health Organization, health is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or injury. So, when talking about health, we must consider the three aspects: physical, mental, and the social. Okay, so for our physical health to be at its optimum, our body should be strong, fit, and free from illness. So eating too less to reduce weight leads to malnourishment and we invite other health problems, while on other hand eating more than required leads to obesity, which is the root cause of many other health issues like diabetes, heart disease, etc. So since both the conditions are very dangerous, so we all must follow a well-balanced diet with a correct gap. But physical health cannot be achieved only by eating right. Just like eating right and at the right time is a must for a healthy body, exercising regularly and correctly plays a very important role to live life with the complete fitness. So I've seen a lot of people engaging into extreme cardio activities and workouts, like running on treadmill or doing cross trainers, but actually while doing this kind of work or workouts, our body gets too tired and stressed, and which can lead to overuse injuries. So we must inculcate a proper balanced approach to working out, a mix of strength training, functional training, some kind of balance exercises, stretching along with proper warm up and cool down is a must. And one thing I've realized after being passionate about fitness is doing the exercise with the right form. So for that I'm really thankful to my fitness trainer Sujit, who is extremely good in his field, and it's only because of his apt guidance that my form and strength is getting better and better. Thank you Sujit for being such a awesome trainer and guide. So here sharing some glimpse of the workouts I love to do.
Don't stop. Don't stop.
hope you got to see some of the workouts I love to do. Okay, so what are the benefits of working out properly? So when we exercise, we release chemicals that makes us feel happy. Okay, and it also helps in strengthening of our muscles, bones and heart, and increasing our lungs capacity. And actually it makes you look good, get fit, and you're able to wear your good old clothes, or like wearing dresses which you have been keeping in your closets from years and waiting to, you know, fit in that. So okay, so now coming to our mental health. Since all aspects of health are interrelated, anything that has negative impact on our thoughts and emotions may affect our all-round health. Some of the tips I would love to share with you all, which I follow on daily basis, is first thing, value yourself. Treat yourself with kindness and respect and avoid self-criticism. Okay, so enjoy a few minutes of me time daily, like, you know, following any hobby, painting, cooking, dancing, etc., whatever makes you feel happy. Okay. The next thing I actually follow is loving yourself first. So why we need to love ourselves first? Because when you love yourself in the first place, no matter what, you will attract others into your life who will love you without conditions. And also the way you treat yourself sets the standard for others. Okay, the next point is surround yourself with good inspirational people that reflect what you want to be and how you want to feel, believe, because energies are contagious. Okay, and the next thing which we should always do is quiet our mind. So how do we achieve that? Meditation and few mindful breaths in and breaths out whenever we are stressed. And sometimes we should do chantings, which can improve the state of our mind and outlook of our life. The other thing which we should inculcate in our daily habit is chanting of some positive affirmations. I always begin and end my day with powerful positive affirmation that gives a super boost to my day. The next point which we should never forget is being grateful. When you are thankful for what you have, you are always rewarded with more. So why not be grateful for all the blessings in our life? Okay, so next thing which we should do is read good books. I love reading good inspirational books, and even reading at least 2-3 pages a day can do wonders to us. The other thing is, I love this quote that what lies before us and what lies behind us are small matters compared to what lies within us. So the meaning of this is like being present now. Being present is the best present we can give to ourselves. So guys, walk, smile, sleep for at least 6 to 8 hours, forgive and love more is the key to great mental health. So the last aspect of health is our social health, which includes our relationships with other people. According to World Health Organization, social health is very important to our overall wellness and well-being. Because having meaningful relationships with other people can reduce stress and provides a sense of security that promotes good emotional health. Okay, so how do we improve our social health? Absolutely not only by sitting on Facebook or social media. So what actually we should be doing is finding people who share our interests. And actually I'm really blessed to have so many friends around me that we all are, you know, having common interests of being fit, or some of the friends are avid readers and some do paintings and many more. So the next thing is choose friends who encourage you to make healthy choices. Surround yourself with people who want to see you successful, and that helps us to reach our goals. So grow your tribe. Okay, so for our busy everyday life, we have so many things to do that we sometimes overlook the importance of maintaining our all-round health. The keyword that should govern our everyday life is a perfect balance. It is not enough to just eat right and exercise well, but we have to be mentally active and engage in activities that makes us feel happier and that makes us interact with the people around us. So health is a complete harmony of body, mind and soul. So guys, this is what I mean by being healthy, and here are the things which I'd share. How I follow my daily routine and keep myself in balance. So guys, this is what I wanted to share with you all today about how I keep a balance on the three basic and most important aspects of health: mind, body and soul. So I'll be looking forward to your routines, how you keep yourself on track on the super hectic and busy days, how you manage to keep a balance on your mind, body and soul. Please comment here and share your daily routines and your passions or hobbies or whatever makes you stay in present and enjoy your life. Do share how do you like the video, and all the suggestions and comments are welcome. And just remember that you create your future by creating your present. So be present now, stay fit, happy and healthy, and enjoy your life. Thank you so much for watching me today, and don't forget to share the video and subscribe the channel. Have a blessed life. Bye bye, take care.